this GIMP tutorial, we will look at 9 different ways to convert a color photo into a black and white image. Some of them are very simple, others are more advanced. The download link for the example image is in the video description. I've opened our image 9 times, so at the end of the video we can compare the effects. We have to keep in mind, however, that the outcome may differ when we use other images than the example image. Make sure the first image tab is active. Now go to Image, Mode, and click on Grayscale. When we want to work with color on this black and white image, we have to go back to Image, Mode, and hit RGB. The image remains black and white, but now we can work on it with color. Activate the second image tab. Now go to Colors and hit Colorify. Here we can just click OK to get our black and white image. Activate the third image tab. Go to Colors and click on Use Saturation. Move the saturation slider all the way to the left. In this option we can also adjust the brightness. Click OK. Click on the fourth image tab. Back to Colors and now to Colorize. Here we have the same options as with Use Saturation. We can bring the saturation slider all the way to the left and adjust the lightness if we want. Click OK. Go to the fifth image tab. Go to the Layers panel and click on the New Layer button. Make the layer fill type white and click OK. Change the mode to saturation or to color. I think color looks best for this image. These are 5 relatively simple and quick methods to convert a color image into black and white. The next options will give us more control over the outcome. Click the sixth image tab. Then go to Colors and hit Desaturate. Here we can try out the 3 different options: Lightness, Luminosity, and Average. No one of these methods is necessarily any better than the other. It really depends on the desired results. I chose lightness for this image. If you are not sure which option to choose, luminosity might be the better one, because this comes closest to how the human eye perceives color. Click OK. Click on the 7th image tab. Then go to Colors, Components, and hit Channel Mixer. Enlarge the dialog box. Zoom in a little and move the image like so. Now check the option Monochrome to get a grayscale image. The 3 values of the red, green and blue channel are in percentage and should add up to 100 when we change them. This can however also be done by GIMP itself when we check the option Preserve Luminosity, so we enable this option. Now we can adjust the separate channels. We want to try to keep as much tonal detail as possible, as well as in the brightest as in the darkest areas. Here are some general rules of thumb. The red channel works well for contrast, particularly in the brighter tones and for skin tones. The green channel will hold most of the details. The blue channel contains grain and often a lot of noise. In this case I've changed the red channel to 60, the green channel to 30 and the blue to 10, but of course feel free to experiment. Click OK. Now we click the 8th image tab. We go back to Colors and Components again, and now we click Decompose. Click on the color model and in the drop-down menu we choose LAB. Make sure that the option Decompose to Layers is selected. Then click OK. Click on the zoom icon in the top right to maximize this image. GIMP has made a new black and white image, so we can close the colored one. Then we go to Layers panel and delete the B as well as the A layer by clicking on the waste bin. Now click on the duplicate button to make a duplicate of the L layer. Change the mode of the copy to multiply. We can, if you want, play around a bit with the opacity. I've kept it, however, 100 for this image. For this method, just as for the next one, we have to go to Image and change the mode back to RGB when we want to work with color on the black and white images. Time now to click the 9th and last image tab. Back to Colors, Components, and Decompose. Now we choose RGB as the color model, and then we click OK. Click on the zoom icon in the top right to maximize this image. Here too, GIMP has made a new image so we can close the colored one. What we see now is the red layer, which we will use. When we make this layer invisible, we can see the green layer, which we will also use. When we make this layer invisible, we see the blue layer, which does not look good, so we will delete it. Make the green and the red layer visible again. Then we activate the top red layer. Make the mode lighten only. Here too we can reduce the opacity to our liking. I made the opacity about 60. Now we can compare the different techniques. Technique number 1, grayscale, and technique number 2, colorify. These two look identical and not very good, especially the red is a bit too dark. Number 3, use saturation looks a bit better. Number 4, colorize is also not so good. Number 5, new layer. And number 6, desaturate look identical and pretty good. Number 7, channel mixer also gives a very nice result. Number 8, decompose to LAB is not my favorite for this image, but I think that number 9, decompose to RGB looks really good. We have to keep in mind, however, that the images we use and our own preference determines which technique we want to use. So feel free to disagree. There is a link in the video description to an in-depth GIMP article on converting color into black and white. I hope all this was helpful. If that's the case, I would appreciate it very much if you would give the video a thumbs up, maybe leave a nice comment, and subscribe if you haven't done already to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.